Flames! Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages. I'm Kirk Hee, and this is The Last Yandere. Okay, been wanting to record this one for a few days, but there's always been something. I should be doing something different today, but I'm not, because I have something coming up in a couple days. It kind of forced me to have to record a bunch of stuff a little earlier than I planned. With that being said, let's get started, guys. Three chapters, much like Sorority writes. Hopefully, this one will end on a happier note. That last one was sort of depressing toward the end of it. Chapter 1. I'll never forget the day the doctors told me I had an inoperable brain tumor. They told me it was a matter of when, and not if. Well, so much for that happy ending! If it's starting off like this with cancer? Why? Whatever. We'll read. We'll hope. I see that there's a horrible border all along this game, all along here. I might just crop things in just a little bit when we go to record, or when we go to edit, rather, just to make it a smidgen a little better looking so it didn't have that border. In any case, let's continue on, guys. There was still so much I wanted to do with my life. I wasn't prepared to die. I begged doctors from all around the country to save my life. No one believed I had any chance of survival. Fortunately, my sister had connections with this huge organization. It was an organization that involved several corporations. They had access to technologies that the public wasn't aware of. They told me they could save me. Totally feels like something that could actually happen in real life. And the reason I say that is because while there's no scientific proof for it, there's been huge leaps and bounds as far as medical marijuana, and I'm not saying do drugs or any of that, but doctors just push pills because it fills their pockets with green. But there's actually someone that lived around here that made a substance from marijuana. I'm not going to say what it is. I'm not going to say how to make it, but she had cancer. He started giving her this stuff in doses every so often. It cured her cancer. Her cancer was gone. The doctors didn't do anything for it. They wanted to do chemotherapy and stuff like that to make her sick. She didn't do it. She did this the natural way, we'll call it. And yeah, she's alive yet to this day. But anyway, these stories always seem to have a way to bring up something in my personal life or in my general area's personal life type deal. Let's continue on. So, these brain surgeons and scientists did something out of the box, or some out of the box procedures on me, and today, I walk this earth cancer-free. What did I just say? I couldn't believe it. I just had brushed off death. It was what motivated me to make the most of my life. Recently, one of the companies involved with this organization asked me to participate in a test of sorts. After they said it to save your life, how could you say no? I mean, like, seriously, I'd be like, I don't want to, but you kind of saved my life, so I sort of owe ya. They said I was only a viable candidate for the test at the time. I agreed. I did owe them my life, after all. This game, it's resonating already, man. Well, there's something that looks a little familiar from the last game. It was cool, actually. All I had to do was touch this huge triangular thing, and I was able to make it fly with my mind. What? I thought that she died, she could fly, or something like that. It would mean that Neuralink technologies was possible. Basically, telepathic communication with electronic devices. Oh, instead of like, hey, Google, I just think, hey, Google, what's square root of pi? Honestly, I don't know that. I don't think anyone would know it right off unless they memorized it. Eventually, this could lead to things like texting without using hands. Might prevent some car crashes. Or drawing on tablets just by staring at the screen. Man, I could become an artist. I keep looking at my tablet because they're referring to it. Imagine playing, Imagine playing apps or mobile games with your mind. Monument Rush 2 would be so much easier. Okay, so that's another apps or game I might have to look into. Although, if it's not connected with this stuff, might just be extra stuff on the side I don't want to rush into right now. When I made that triangular thing fly, they were ecstatic. But when it came to weapons testing, I couldn't make it work. They said I lacked a killer instinct. I didn't know if it was a joke or not. I did look like a wuss. Eventually, they said, ow, I bit my tongue. I bit my tongue hard enough that it bled a little bit. Oh, that's gonna be sore when I go to eat supper. Eventually, they sent me on their way, but they do mail me medicine to suppress the possible regrowth of my tumor. Okay, so here I am, fully healthy and well-functioning individual. Well, almost. I just finished my second college course, and I'm now a designer. A graphic designer that's talented, but flops at his design pitches. His? Okay, I thought we were reading as a female all this time. Despite beating all the challenges, I still couldn't overcome my stage fright, and lack of confidence overall. Make a YouTube channel! I was literally afraid to talk to people in any sense. Freaking recently, I was in a crowd of 50 or so, giving a damn speech at a wedding. Just, boom. Just something I'd never be able to do. I credit YouTube for it. Or my guts of actually starting up my own channel. It's just leaps and bounds, guys. Just leaps and bounds. In the case, I've got to stop interrupting or else it's going to be a 2-hour video. Both banes of my love life and career, but I'm just confident in my graphic design. Well, there you go. We're finally into the story. Geez, are you planning to use that SAP story for your pitch? Okay, so I feel like I should be talking like this all of a sudden. Because of that funky mustache. I won't, though. I will resist that because that's probably horribly offensive, even though it's just meant to be in jest. Not meant to offend. Hey, sis, I didn't know you'd be home early. Well, I'm glad I did. Word of advice, little bro. If you're going to sell yourself, focus on you. No one really cares about your story. Really? I've been telling you guys secret stuff about me all the time. You don't care? Why? That's a little harsh. People only care about what you do for them. It's a fact of life. I'm sorry, sis. It's just that that's the story I'm most confident to tell. People don't care about huge organizations or any of these magic science voodoos unless it affects their lives directly. Oh, and what you said about not being confident? Don't tell them that. Are you trying to win over Apsir or nah? So I guess we are trying to get a job at Apsir Games. This is where the meta comes in this one, I guess. You better get this job at Apsir Inc. so you can move out of my house. Oh, and get a girlfriend too, okay? I'm not going to give you a middle finger, but screw you, woman. Wow, and this coming from you. You haven't had a boyfriend in years. You haven't had a boyfriend in years. What I'm supposed to read, I just took laughing. Hey, at least I had relationships. Not like you. Ha ha. Ouch. I'll be gone for a few weeks. Company outing. If you need anything, call me. Don't forget to take your medicine, okay? We don't want that pesky tumor coming back, do we? Good luck, little brother. Go get your dream job. Awesome. I bid my sister farewell and I walk anxiously to Apsir's address. No, Apsir's is surprisingly hard to say. I don't know why. I think it's because it's all one word the way it's wrote and you want to say it like Apsir's. But in any case, however, I wasn't so sure where it was exactly. Probably should have checked that out before you left, dude. I see a cute little cake shop. I decide to head in to ask for directions. Wait, isn't this just her sister, but with different hair? She looks a lot like her. Good morning. Would you like to buy a cake? I'd be like, no, cakes are expensive. I'm just here for directions. They're all freshly baked and pretty tasty. I was not expecting choices. So, I'm not here for cake. Why not? What's the point of going to a cake shop if you're not going to buy cake? Sorry, miss. I came here to ask for directions to the Absor office. I'm a little lost at the moment. Not really familiar with the area. What the heck, I'll buy one. So my choice really didn't have a choice. It just opened up a little bit of a different dialogue. We're still buying a damn cake. I hope it could help me, though. Or I hope you could help me, though. Yay, you're in for a treat. So, which flavor would you like? Strawberry or chocolate? If it's strawberry shortcake, chocolate for sure. Friggin' hate strawberry shortcakes. Horrible. Horrible. It's just horrible. We'll go with the chocolate. So just be on the safe side. Chocolate? That's almost as sweet as I am. Good one. You made my day. I really needed that. To be honest, I'm a little off today. I'm just not together. We'll have to take his word for it. All I can see is his head. Why? What's happening? Big presentation. And it's for Absor Inc. You know where the office is? Oh, I know where their office is at. It's, the red orangish building across the street. She had to think that hard on it? It's literally across the street? I would just said there. Pointed where it was. So I'm not lost after all. I'm right where I'm supposed to be. Thanks, miss. Oh, yes, you're right where you're supposed to be. Close to me. Okay, that's very strong. You're really funny. Funny how? Like I'm a clown? I amuse you? Oh, no, nothing like that. I'm just playing with you, silly. Good luck, sir. Enjoy your cake. Oh, no, wait, don't go. Stay here. No, don't do that. Just go. Goodbye. Okay, that was very weird. I headed outside and see the building the cake shop lady told me about. I didn't realize Absor's office was so near. I think they'd have some sort of sign. Like, there's nothing. I checked my watch. 2 p.m. Still an hour early. I still had lots of time to spare. I go back in. Ask for that lady's number. Had I realized it earlier, I would have stayed and talked a while longer. That cake shop lady was kind of cute. She's kind, too. She was really fun to talk to. Wonder if she's like that to every customer. Hope not. Maybe it was all a sales talk. Building rapport is part of marketing, after all. She was so cool. I should have asked for her name. No wonder I'm perpetually single. If I come back here just to ask her out, she'll think I'm a creep customer or something. I'm sure she gets asked out all the time. She sees new faces every day, and I'm sure some of them have more guts than me. And if I go back there to ask her out, it wouldn't exactly be a bold move for her. Perpetual singlehood. He's just overthinking it right now. And you guys know how to write a character. This is a character that, once again, like with sorority rights, I feel I can relate to this dude in this sense. And I'll use Rocket League as an example because it's something that's been happening with me in that a lot. Rocket League lately, I've been playing it by myself, no time for friends to play and whatnot, and I keep making myself intentionally play bad. Unintentionally, it's just I keep getting in my head. I keep saying I'll miss the ball once or something, or someone will score on us within like a few seconds, and it's like right there, the switch is flipped, and I'm thinking, that's my fault. I was the reason that went in, and then I start missing everything. If I can get out of that mindset, I start playing good again. It's frustrating, guys. It's frustrating. Okay, new game plan. I'll make up for this. Next time I see a cute girl, I'm going to ask that girl out. He should really be stepping back in there. She was flirting the hell out of that. Okay, I just realized I'm not too nervous about the Absor meeting anymore. Guess this got it off my mind. I really need Absor to approve my proposed designs. Jagger and Jones got a sweet deal out of them. Hope I do too. I don't know what Jagger and Jones is, but okay. I'm guessing they're his friends. I enter Absor's conference hall. Looks like I got here a little too early. Hello? What can I do for you? Are you here for the meeting? Yes. I'm here for a meeting with Mr. Guerrero. This girl's so cute. I made a promise to myself. I have to ask this girl out. Oh, it's you. Didn't you get the text? We had to postpone. Oh, that sucks. We had to postpone the meeting. Text? I don't remember my phone ringing this afternoon. I checked my pockets. I couldn't find my phone. Oh, no. Text? Oh, no. I seem to have left my phone somewhere. That's too bad. I hope you find your phone soon. Pardon my manners. My name's Mia. Hello, Mia. Unfortunately, the Absurd CEO missed his flight, so your meeting has been moved to tomorrow. No problem. I'm available for tomorrow. The question is, are you? Like, this is the worst possible time he could be, like, attempting to ask someone out. He's potentially going to be working there. He's applying for a job there. This could really ruin things for him. You don't do that. If things go wrong, she could potentially say, you know, this guy's a creeper. Just do not hire him. Oh, that idiot. Okay, so at least I have a choice. I'm going to make this the less creepy option because I don't want to sabotage his chance of getting the job. I hope this in the end doesn't end up making it so I don't have a choice, much like in the first one. You know, you want to buy a cake or don't want to buy a cake? Yes, to be honest, I have some hard questions for you tomorrow. See? She's throwing the questions at us. I made the right choice once again, in my opinion. Why don't we have a preliminary discussion today? 3 times it took for me to get the word preliminary out. It's coming out as blah, blah. If only to speed up the proceedings for tomorrow's meeting. That's actually not a bad idea at all. So shall we talk about it here, or... Nah, I think we should take this outside. That's weird. Why? I think it'll be romantic. There's a nice restaurant. We're not doing this. This is like the horrible choice. Dude, you don't hit on the person you're doing an interview with. Huh? I'm here to propose a new design for Absurd, right? There's this Rusto I did design work for as well. Oh. If I showed it to you in person, it'll look much more impressive. Just promise me that if you like it, you'll put in a good word for me. Okay, makes sense. Meet me at the parking lot in 2 hours. I'll get some work done first. In the meantime, maybe look for your phone or something. I'll see you at 5. Don't be late. Technically, I got to ask the girl out, but I shouldn't be a creep about it. This is purely business. And getting her to say yes was a confidence boost, though. And it's not like I tricked her or anything. That restaurant is a pretty good showcase of my work. The logo, the palettes, the menus, everything looks great. Courting her shouldn't be my goal here. Getting Absurd as my client should be my top priority. There you go, dude. Still, it would be nice to get her number, though. Wait. I still need to look for my phone. I must have left it at home. I'm pretty sure. It's 3 p.m. now. Not much traffic on my way home. As soon as I arrive home, I start turning my house upside down, trying to look for the phone. I should probably just start by moving the odd little thing instead of turning everything upside down. One, that's going to take a lot of skill, a lot of manpower, and a lot of effort. Just searching through stuff. Not quite the hassle. I'm sorry, guys. I couldn't resist. Not here. Could I have been robbed? Oh yeah, I'm sure that's it. Nah, I must have dropped it on the way to Absurd's. How could you drop a phone and not hear it hit the freaking ground? I mean, we'll take this as a phone. It's a remote, but it's the same weight. Pretty sure you guys heard that. And I hope I didn't break that. I don't think I broke it. It's still adjusting stuff on my TV. Awesome. I decided to give up on my search. I didn't have much time left. I clenched and unclenched my fingers. I thought I was going to say I clenched my buttocks. It's just where my brain went. Stressed. How can I be so careless? With a sigh of resignation, I call my network provider to report my missing phone. I grimace. I then open up my laptop to change the passwords for all my social media accounts. Oh man, that's time consuming if he has a lot of different accounts and sites he's set up to. I don't even know what to say about all this. How do you be so careless with something that's so expensive? I post a status telling my new friends to delete my old number. I hope someone actually reads it. I run back to Absurd's parking lot. I pick up my watch, reveals I'm already 10 minutes late. Great second impression there, dude. Mia must be pissed. And there's a cake shop lady. We gotta get her name. Cake shop lady just does not do it justice. Oh, hey. Hi. I don't know where she... I mean, hello. Cake shop customer guy. Nice seeing you. What? You left your phone in the cake shop. I decided to wait for you here to return this. My name is Kara Gintner? Yeah, we're just gonna call her Kara from now on. By the way, it's not fair for me to introduce myself. Sorry, I already know your name. Had to go through your phone to figure out who it belongs to. How'd she know the password to get into it? Unless this guy doesn't use that password or use any amount of security to keep his phone locked. Idiot, if that's the case. I suppose it might just be an older style phone, like a flip phone or something like that. That has the very basic functions, but whatever. I learned a lot about you. A little too much. Hi. I'm guessing that's meant to be hee hee. So it's only fair you get to know me too. Oh my gosh, thank you. It's alright. You saved me a ton of trouble. Thanks, Kara. You're a great friend. Is he seriously friend zoning her already? Friend? Like I said, is he already friend zoning her? Yep. Alright. Yeah, I'll be your bestest friend. Your only friend too, if you want. I love you as a friend. Made a great friend today. So, how do I repay your kindness? Oh my god. We can, go to the park? Watch a romantic sunrise? As great friends! Why is she gone so head over heels over him already? This is just creepy. Sounds good, Kara. But I already got this thing playing with this girl from Apsir. Oh no. She's gonna lose it over this, isn't she? By the way, have you seen a short-haired blonde with glasses around here? We were supposed to meet here a while ago, but I came in a little late. Oh, that... I never seen that girl in my life. How could I have seen her? Why ask me? Oh, she must have been pissed off and left. Or she must have been pissed and left, same difference. Forget about her. We two are going to have a great time. As friends. Yay. I love the friend zone. Oh man, she's going to go crazy and kill people, isn't she? Or maybe she already has killed someone. Right. Best of all, there won't be any pests to get in our way, in the way of our love. Lovely time, right? It's just so weird. Funny thing, I already announced that I lost my phone, so no texts or calls tonight, I guess. Good. We walked it to get... Man, does this chapter ever end? I know I've interrupted stuff a lot, but man, we're half an hour in. I was going to think about putting one chapter per video, but depending on how long this is, I may need to split it up into two. We'll see after all the mistakes I made, I cut out, just see where this lands, how long it'll be. We walk together and make our way to the park. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly dark. I noticed Kara was doing her best trying to flirt with me. More than that, I'm surprised how obvious she was. Just a few hours ago, I was 99% sure I'll be single forever. That said, this day has been one hell of a ride. Looks like we got here just in time. So, how did the presentation go? Did you impress them with your dashing good looks? I bet you did. No, the meeting got moved to tomorrow. To be honest, I'm still nervous about it. I'd be even more nervous now because he missed his rendezvous, so to speak, with the woman supposed to be interviewing him tomorrow. But we know, I can just about guarantee you she's not going to be there. Eh? You shouldn't. You're a great guy. Do you know how Apsir Inc. is? See, Apsir comes out as Apsir with me at times. I don't know why. They're a little hard to please. How'd you know? Well, there was this girl I met from Apsir. She sounded so strict and serious. Did you think she was pretty? Yeah, you know, business types. Real prim and proper. Sounds like she was quite the looker. You must have liked her. Uh-huh. Reminded me of my former business partner. Looked like her. Former? Do you still see her? Jill? No. You know how it is. I with the very obvious noticeable crazies she has, I'd be hesitant to mention any names here. I'm sure you picked up on the way that I interpreted her voice. I tend to read it a little faster, and I don't know, you guys are seeing it. Sounds vague. Does she live near you? Does she have means of contacting you? Nope. Anyway, maybe you'll have some insider info about Apsir. Why would I? Well, since you like to work across the street from them and all, maybe you got something? Yeah, I know about Apsir. I played their games a lot. My favorite is this runner game called, it's called, oh, I'm bound to get this wrong. Minuscule Rush? No, Majestic Rush? That's it. Monument Rush? It's called Monument Rush, Kara. I read that horribly wrong. Whatever. We'll go with it. Oh, yeah. But I assure you, I'm a fan. It's a pretty good game, right? Playing it was all I ever did before things got complicated. Anyway, like I was saying, I really like it. Complicated? What do you mean? Oh, that look he had on. I have to do it. Kara? You're scaring me. I can kind of see why. She's just sitting there staring, going, every now and then. I'd be wondering what the hell's going on with her, too. I'd be like, are you okay? Do you need me to take you somewhere? Do you need some sort of medication to help this? And then she'd get mad at me. And then I'd probably be in huge trouble. Because she's scaring me a little bit, to be honest. Much like him. I have a confession to make. What is it, Kara? Well, the scene just changed so suddenly. What if the world ended in 2 weeks? What would you do? I guess I'd enjoy my last hours on Earth. Make the most of every second. You know what I'd do? I think you'd... I don't know. I don't know you well enough. First, I'd find a way to survive. And then, I'd hope for the best. And then, I'd tell you, I love you. Now she's got him doing it. I have to go. Maybe for him, he's just been sitting there. The whole time, just dumbfounded. Well, that was an abrupt end to the chapter. Okay, so we found out that she loved him. Well, it was blatantly obvious from the get-go, let's admit that. But yeah, obviously, chapter 2, we're officially ending things here. Man, I hope this one has save points because I don't want to button mash my way through all this again, because this is probably the only chapter I'm going to read today. Because I've got a few more videos I got to get recorded. I hate to even say that one here. I've got to help my uncle find his dog. He's an old dog, and we're worried that he may have got out somewhere and couldn't get back up. He's old, he doesn't walk around well. So I'm trying to rush through this stuff a little bit so I can get to helping him with that. So yeah, this is where we're going to end things. This is where I'll keep things short. Fingers crossed, we find his dog. Wish me luck on that one, guys. By the time this comes out, you'll probably know one way or the other whether we found him or not. In any case, guys. If you haven't enjoyed this video, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. I really appreciate that. I hate where that screen goes bright every time I do that. If you want to, you can follow me on Twitter at KirkEehe. Subscribe here on YouTube. Hit that little notification bell and be part of the... I don't want to say notification squad anymore. I want something unique. Be a part of the... Yeehee's knees? I don't know. I don't have anything, guys. Just hit that notification bell. Be always notified of my daily content. In any case, my God, am I stuttering today. Really weird, because I don't stutter like this that often. But, Top Buzz Instagram. Those of you that follow me over there, see this stuff over there. Awesome. Hope you're enjoying the thumbnails I put out in a couple days in advance to give you a sneak peek. And sometimes a little funny clips I'll put over there. Or... in the case of one Mega Man Maker that's coming out on the day I'm recording, the meta rocket going across, breaking out of the game. I don't know why I did that, but it just came to my mind when I did it. In any case, guys, Top Buzz, Instagram, those links and more, description down below, as always. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to chapter two to this. I'm just waiting for, and I'm expecting it in chapter two. He'll go to the meeting. The woman that's supposed to be there for the questions, she's not going to be there. We're going to find out she's dead. If we don't, I'll be shocked. I will be shocked. But I look forward to this. Hopefully, I'll be able to record sometime again over the weekend, though I don't think I'll be able to. It's supposed to be quick, so I'm going to leave this for the lesson short. See you later, guys. Got my new YouTube pals. I'm Kirk Hee Hee, but of course, I'm always Kirk Hee Hee. Ha ha! See you guys in the next video.